Maimon Har Sinai is probably the most transformative event that happened in world history, because essentially this is the beginning of monotheism in the world, to spread to the world. It's the one time when God reveals himself to a people. Now, what circumstantial proofs do we have, so to speak? It's interesting, one second. It's interesting that if you look at all major world religions, all of them agree, in other words, Christianity and Islam, they all agree that God gave the Torah to Mount Sinai, that God gave the Torah to the Jews on Mount Sinai. Christians believe it, Muslims believe it, and some crazy Orthodox Jews believe it, right? That God gave the Torah to the Jews on Mount Sinai. One second. It says in the Torah that every single Jew was there and every single Jew heard it. So the question is, if you want to start a religion, don't you think that the best way to start a religion is to bring everybody together and to say, okay, guys, here's the details of the religion, now go practice it? Or is it better to tell one guy or girl and give them the job of telling it to all the people? Which one's better? God speaking to everybody? Or God speaking to one person and that one person speaking to, what?
He could just be lying.
Right, exactly. So the question is, Christianity, Islam, Orthodox Jews, right? We all believe that God spoke to the Jews on Mount Sinai to start off the religion, so to speak. Why is it that according to the Christian, or according to the Muslim, when God, so to speak, added on to it and changed his mind, why did he only convene it through one person? Why did he relay that message just through one person? Why did he bring everyone together again and say, oh guys, guess what? The Torah that I gave you doesn't count anymore. Oh guys, guess what? The Torah that we gave you, well, instead you got to be a Muslim, you got to do this. Wouldn't that make more sense?
Yeah.
And not only that, but if you're going to start a religion, bring everybody together. Why does no other major world religion claim that God brought everyone together, spoke to them, and then they practice it? Right? Mormons don't believe this. Buddhists don't believe this. Right? Mormons believe Joseph Smith had the great message. Buddhists believe Siddhartha Gautama had the great message. Why don't they say, God brought everyone together and said, Siddhartha Gautama is my prophet. God brought everyone together and said, Joseph Smith is my prophet. You know why? Says the Khazari, you can't fake it. You can't make 2 to 3 million people believe they experienced something that they didn't experience. The Torah says we were all there. How would the Torah ever get accepted as a book of truth if we weren't in fact all there? At what point do you slip this into the history? At what point do you slip it in? The Torah says 3 million Jews stood on Mount Sinai and heard God speak. We accept that book as truth. How do you ever get that book accepted as truth if that didn't actually happen? Not only that, but we have a mitzvah to remember it. We have many mitzvahs to remember it. We have Pesach to talk about. We go again and again and again, talk about, teach it. If it didn't happen, how would this book ever get accepted as truth? So says the Khazari, the reason why no other major world religion bothers to say that God spoke to all of them is because there's no way to fake it. The fact that we say it and make such a claim, and we accept that as truth, still 3,000 years later, must be that the generation that accepted this truth, it actually happened to that generation, and then they transmitted it to us.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.